This is the first in a two-part video series that will address the reconciliation process districts are required to complete every January. Remember that the main goal of the reconciliation process is to compare the students reported for membership in the district's September 2017 PI 1563 with those reported in the January 2018 PI 1563, and to identify, explain, and document how the student counts have changed. The reconciliation process focuses on your district resident student count, but you will quickly find out that knowing who your non-residents are will be just as important. So what's the best way to do this? Well, in a perfect world, you'd be able to line up side by side, grade by grade, the two lists of resident students used in each count to clearly see which names appear in one and not the other. But while this may work for small and mid-sized districts, it's not feasible for districts with thousands of students. For larger districts, it's more likely you will need to get reports from your student record system that identify student status changes, such as enrollment, residency, or program changes. And you'll also need to have at hand any notes you may have made while doing the individual September and January PI 1563 reports. These system reports and your hand notes will give you the information that will help explain the differences you find in your reconciliation. We'll discuss the reports and the data you may want to get out of your system as we work through our sample reconciliation. So let's assume we've submitted our January PI 1563 membership report, found the reconciliation spreadsheet on the DPI School Financial Services website, saved it to our local computer, opened it up, pulled down our district to load the data, and verified that the student numbers and categories we see in columns 1 and 5 of our reconciliation spreadsheet match exactly what is in the School Financial Services Reporting Portal, or SFPupil, for those two reports for our district. You want to be sure to do all this prep work so that you know you are reconciling the exact data DPI has for your district. One last thing before we start the reconciliation. I just want to draw your attention to the Instructions tab in the Excel workbook. It contains a written set of instructions on the reconciliation process. So returning to our reconciliation sample, notice that the total September resident pupil count in column 1 is 469, and the total January resident pupil count in column 5 is 457, a net loss of 12, which we see in column 6. Column 6 is the unreconciled difference between the two counts. Also notice there are specific categories that are showing a variance in column 6. Preschool special education has a net gain of 2, 5K, 5 full days, has a net gain of 1, and grades 1 to 12 has a net loss of 15. Our mission is to identify the students that are causing the differences between the two counts in these categories. This district has under 500 students, so it's likely they would be able to do a side-by-side comparison of the names or just look at the class lists. But because we have video viewers from all sizes of districts, let's say they are running system reports. In all cases, regardless of size, we recommend the first report you run from your student record system is of the students enrolling after the third Friday in September. Think about it. If they enrolled after the third Friday in September, they would not have been included in the third Friday count, the number you see in column 1 in your reconciliation spreadsheet. And also remember that you're looking only for district residents in this reconciliation, but it's certainly feasible that non-residents have also enrolled. So on the screen, you see a mock-up of what you might see on that report, the list of residents that have enrolled after the third Friday in September. Your list might be much longer, but in any case, look through that list of students. Make sure all the data for all the students appears. For instance, if you see a student does not have a grade or program indication, you'll have to go back to whoever maintains your student record database and get that corrected, because you'll need for all the data to have been entered correctly. You actually may end up cleaning up the student record database during this reconciliation process. So returning to the list, we see that two preschool students have enrolled since the third Friday, Rick James and Sandy Souther. Our reconciliation spreadsheet for this membership category indeed is a difference of 2. January has more, 2 more than September. So it seems like we actually have identified our answer. So we enter the two additions into our category, the preschool special education category, and notice that the difference column in column 6 has now gone to 0, which totally explains that category. Looking at the next category in our report, 5K, 5 day, we see one new student, Carrie Atkinson, has enrolled, So we turn to our reconciliation spreadsheet and enter her as an addition. And we see that that category has now been set to zero. We have explained all the differences in that category. So that's it for students enrolling after September 15th. So next we will run a report of the residents that were enrolled before and on the third Friday in September, but withdrew before the second Friday in January. Think about this. If they were enrolled before and on the third Friday, we would expect these students to have been included in the September count. But if they withdrew before the January count, they would not be included in January. So on the screen, we see a mock-up of our second report, which indeed we find our 15 withdrawals, all of which are in grades 1 to 12. So we return to our reconciliation spreadsheet, entering 15 in the subtractions column, and we find that that also explains, in this category, all the differences, because our difference is 0, and also our net difference has now arrived at 0, which is what we were looking for. We are done when we have reconciled all the individual categories to 0, and the bottom line is 0. This example was intentionally clear and straightforward. In the real world, you will likely have both enrollees and withdrawals in the same category, and you might even see the same student on both the enrollee and withdrawal lists. Use the data exactly as you get it from your system reports, entering it into the reconciliation spreadsheet. After you have all the changes explained, complete with student names and how they have contributed to the overall change, you are done with your district's reconciliation. Keep the reconciliation and system reports as backup. This was actually a quick and easy reconciliation, as we were able to get to zero by just getting a couple of reports from our student record system. Of course, things are never this easy. The Lesson 7 video will delve into five more complex examples you will likely encounter.